You're listening to the X-Zone Radio Show live and around the world on the Talkstar Radio Network. Visit us online at
www.xzone-radio.com.
The X-Zone Radio and TV show is largely an opinion talk show. All opinions, comments, or statements of fact expressed by Rob McConnell's guests are strictly their own and are not to be construed as those of the X-Zone Radio and TV show or in any manner endorsed by Rob McConnell, rel-mar McConnell Media Company, Talkstar Radio Network, its affiliated stations, or employees.
X-Zone, a place where fact is fiction and fiction is reality. Now, here's your host, Rob McConnell.
I made love to an alien near Roswell last night. We strolled along together in the pale moonlight. I had a funny feeling that something wasn't right. I made love to an alien last night. When she gripped my hand, I was feeling mighty fine, but her fingers with mine would not intertwine. When I bent down and gazed into her eyes, they were big as donuts and blacker than the sky.
Welcome back, everyone. My name is Rob McConnell, and you're listening to the X-Zone Radio Show on the Talkstar Radio Network and our fine family of broadcast affiliates across Canada, the United States, Central America, the Caribbean, South America, the Pacific Rim, 20 Asian countries, and across Europe. Our toll-free number is 1-877-528-8255. That's toll-free throughout the U.S., Canada, Alaska, and Hawaii at 1-877-528-8255. My email address, xzone@xzoneradio.com, on MSN Messenger, talkstarradio@hotmail.com, and our websites, www.xzoneradio.com and www.xzonetv.com. As always, we try our very best to make sure that the archives go up on iTunes right after the show, usually within the first 2 hours after the show. So let me see, at 2 o'clock Eastern, so by 4 o'clock Eastern or 1 o'clock Pacific, you should be able to go to iTunes and download the radio show version of the X-Zone. The TV, well, that takes us a little bit more time because there's a lot of editing that has to be done and the files are bigger, so we have to. It takes us until the following day at the earliest, 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So about 12 hours after the show, the TV show is up on iTunes as well. My guest this hour is no stranger to the X-Zone. Nick Pope used to run the British government's UFO project at the Ministry of Defense. Now, initially, Nick was skeptical. His research and investigation into the UFO phenomenon, however, convinced him that whatever the nature of the UFO phenomena, it raised important defense, national security, and air safety issues. He was particularly interested in the cases where witnesses were pilots or where the UFOs were tracked on radar. Nick also looked into other mysteries such as alien abductions, crop circles, and ghosts. He is recognized as a leading authority on the unexplained, does extensive media work, lectures all around the world, and has acted as a consultant on numerous television series and documentaries. And Nick Pope, welcome back to the X-Zone.
Thank you, Rob. It's great to be back on the show.
Super having you with us, Nick. Let me see. The last time you were on, I don't think that the MOD had released its UFO files. So can you update us on the significance of the release of the UFO files?
Yes, I think it's twofold. Just to put it into historical context, it was December of 2007 that the Ministry of Defense confirmed that they'd made a policy decision to release their entire archive of UFO files. Now, some material had been released already and was available at our national archives, but there were many, many hundred more files to be released, and that, when looked at cumulatively, constitute tens of thousands of individual documents. Now, that process is going to be a 2 to 3 year program, and it's going to be done in batches. There are a number of releases, and two of them have taken place already. The first batch of files was released in May last year, and the second batch in October. And what I think is significant about this, two things. Firstly, of course, the material itself. People can now go to the National Archives website and view some of these files. But the second thing, and this is particularly interesting to me, is that this release of material, which includes sightings from police officers, sightings from pilots, UFOs tracked on radar, this release has shifted the ground here in the United Kingdom. And in terms of the way in which the media and the public see the UFO issue, the coverage that the release of these documents has gotten has propelled the UFO subject from being a sort of fringe issue.
Nick, you and I have to take a two-minute break. Please stand by. We'll be right back. Nick Pope is our special guest. NickPope.com.
Modern Esoteric, Beyond Our Senses by Brad Olson, consummates the lifeology story about where humanity originates. It is the lost continents, the primitive wisdom, the mythos of creation, and the rethinking of ancient history as we are taught in academia. There is much more to the story than what we have been told. As this is the first book in the Esoteric series, Modern Esoteric starts at the beginning of time and accelerates up to this modern age. Future Esoteric is book two in the series and takes a forward-looking position ahead of today with an open and honest examination of the ET issue and various unexplained phenomena. To discover the writings of author Brad Olson, visit www.bradolson.com. That's www.bradolson.com. Named one of the world's greatest psychics, Elizabeth Joyce is now giving readings worldwide via Skype. Elizabeth Joyce is recognized for her clairvoyant ability to help find missing persons, her analysis of dreams, past life regression work, mediumship, and her accurate predictions. Elizabeth has been a frequent guest on the X-Zone radio show with yours truly, Rob McConnell, now for several years. For an appointment with Elizabeth Joyce, call 201-934-8986 or Skype at elizabeth.joyce. And for more information, you can always visit Elizabeth Joyce online at www.new-visions.com.
Have a disease that you would like to alleviate through a natural means? Have you been contacted by angels, ghosts, or even extraterrestrials and want to validate these experiences? Or would you simply like to speak with someone who can help you find your life's purpose? I'm Dr. Joseph Mara, and I'm offering my services free of charge for first-time clients contacting me during the month of April. These free consultations include angel card readings, guided meditations, life coaching, and energy healing. If you have always wanted to explore these types of experiences but were skeptical or simply could not afford them, then take advantage of this free special offer. Contact me through my website, aguidinglight.com, to schedule your consultation today. Until then, I offer you love, light, and laughter.
Pretty melody.
gang, I made a major foobar. It's nickpope.net, not nickpope.com. It's www.nickpope.net. And Nick is with us again. Nick, the significance of the release of the file certainly did give the public access to more information that they ever had before, but was there any smoking gun within the information that was released?
No, there wasn't, in terms of there being a sort of spaceship in a hangar, that sort of thing. I think a body of people were hoping that there was going to be that kind of documentation. There wasn't, and there won't be. If there is such a smoking gun, even I didn't have access to it. So I'm not going to be sort of saying to people, prepare yourselves for some great revelation of an extraterrestrial presence. What I will be saying is prepare yourself for lots more very interesting UFO cases in the files.
Now, Nick, there were two incidents last year involving near misses between UFOs and police helicopters. What happened?
Yes, there was one incident in Wales where a police helicopter, this was in June of last year, a police helicopter was coming into land at an airbase in Wales, and suddenly the pilots saw a UFO fairly close to them. There's then some dispute about what happened next. According to some media reports, the helicopter attempted to give chase. The police, in response to an FOI request, whilst they confirmed that a near miss that a sighting had taken place, they denied that a chase had ensued. The second incident took place over Birmingham, which is the UK's second most populous city. And this time, the incident was classified not as a UFO sighting, but actually as a near miss involving an unidentified object. And that's a subtle difference, but it's important because it affects who investigates. This was investigated by something called the Air Proximity Board, which is jointly sponsored by the Ministry of Defence and our Civil Aviation Authority, the equivalent of your FAA in the States. And they basically, again, this report has been published on the Internet and shows that the pilot genuinely thought there was some danger of a collision and had to take evasive action.
1-877-528-8255 is toll-free throughout the U.S., Canada, Alaska, and Hawaii. Nick Pope is our special guest. And Nick's website is www.nickpope.net. Now, Nick, there was also an alleged collision between a UFO and a wind turbine. What's your take on what happened there?
Well, this is an interesting one. This took place on January the 7th this year, and some local people in Lincolnshire saw some strange lights in the sky. And then at 4 in the morning, some of them were woken up by what they thought was a loud explosion. And in the morning, they found that one of the turbines at a wind farm had been damaged. Now, these things are about 290 feet high, and each of the three blades are 66 feet in length. One blade had been knocked off, and the other had been warped, been bent out of shape completely. Now, they took some residue from the damaged blade to the manufacturers in Germany. We were promised the results within days. It actually took about a month. And then they said, well, there was no evidence of a collision. So that's pretty much where the story rests, all fairly inconclusive. The site was searched with a metal detector.
Right.
The waters were then muddied by, quote, Ministry of Defense insiders, unquote, suggesting that some prototype drone may have been involved. But it's all a bit of a mystery. The really significant thing, I think, was that Britain's best-selling national daily newspaper, The Sun, put this on the front page as their main headline. And it's the second time UFOs have been front-page news here in the